Welcome, everybody, to an ornithological show. I'm a wise old owl that's bird, I'm sure you know. Our story begins inside a nest, where the grown-ups are about to tell their four young children they all learned to fly.
But this won't be so easy, you may have already guessed, because flying on their own will mean leaving that cozy nest.
So let's all see what happens when the grown-ups make their case. We hope our little tale will leave a smile on every face.
Okay, children, today's the day you start your flying lessons. We'll take it nice and easy for the beginning sessions.
Oh, that's okay, Pops. No need for that. There's nothing you should fear. We're not flying anywhere, because...
We like it here.
What? Orville, Wilbur, Amelia, Harriet, what are you saying?
That's right, Daddy-O. No need to catch some air. Other birds might fly around, but we're...
Not going anywhere.
Oh, don't be silly, children. You can't stay here forever.
We can if you keep feeding us, you see.
We're very clever.
And once you all learn to fly, we'll have a nice reception. I've got worms for treats.
So, who would like to go first?
Orville, Wilbur, Amelia, Harriet...
Oh, come now.
Certainly one of you is brave enough to fly.
She'll go.
What? What are you talking about? I'm too young to die. Someone else should try it first. I don't want to fly.
Don't want to fly? Of course you do.
And when you do, we'll all be so proud of you.
But...
Listen, children, flying for the first time is scary, that's true.
You'll get a little push and then it's up to you.
Thank you. know just what to do, and you'll be soaring up in the sky so bright and so blue.
Do my best to fly.
Everybody look up below.
Orville's going to give it a go.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Blast off!
I'm flying.
You're flying, but we still like it here.
You see? Look at Orville.
He's flying on his very first try.
Yeah, but he's always been bigger than me, and I'm just a regular guy.
Size is not what matters when you're taking to the sky.
Small can be a good thing. Small can be a good thing when you're learning how to fly.
We're small, but we can zip.
Up, down, and all around, we fly in every trip.
Words, now it's easy to do.
this, and then you'll be flying just like a hummingbird.
Cause a big sensation.
Not only are they flying, but they're flying in formation.
Some reluctant birds here who do not want to fly.
It seems they are afraid, you know.
And that you're letting them take it slow?
Slow? Slow? You can't take it nice and slow.
Full speed is the way to go.
Wilbur is about to try his first flight.
Sergeant, do you have the advice that will help him keep it right?
Of course he does, of course he does. He'll tell me what to do.
Just take a flying leap and we'll be here for you.
Thank you, all my feathered friends. With you here, I can do it.
Of course you can, my chickadee. There's really nothing to it.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here.
Sergeant Gander, thank you for helping this family out.
No problem. And if you need more help, don't hesitate to shout.
Sergeant Gander, it's time to go.
We have to go and feed.
But don't forget when we line up
that it's my turn to lead.
Honk, 2, 3, 4. Honk, 2, 3, 4.
Honk, 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 honk.
Only two birds left.
Now what do you think they'll do?
Maybe they'll stay home forever and clean and make the stew.
Here come the raptors. Everybody, duck!
Maybe they won't see us if we have any rocks.
be like those guys. Vine rapping is the best.
Well, you'll never get to do it, Amelia, if you don't leave your cozy nest.
Okay, here I go.
Look, she's flying!
I'm flying.
She's flying, but I still like it here.
Of course she is, Harriet. So can you, only if you try. She really wants to try it, but she's just too scared to fly.
Everyone gets frightened when they try something new.
But you don't need to worry,
because we're all here for you.
If you need a leg to stand on, the flamingos will be there too.
If you need some formal wear, the penguins have suits for you.
You see, you're never going to be far away from someone who can help you out.
Because if you find yourself in trouble, someone will help you out.
All the birds will help you, just look into our eyes.
For owls have lots of experience and we are very wise.
With all your friends around you, you can do amazing things.
Now you don't have to be afraid, it's time to spread your wings.
You don't need extra time to plan, just go get out there.
But you don't have to do it alone.
It's okay. We have lots of help. So we never have to be on our own.
Aunts, uncles, sisters, and brothers.
Friends, neighbors, and plenty of others.
Teachers, parents, and all of the rest
will help us become our very best.
Thank you, everyone. I think I'm ready to try.
Are you going to spread your wings and see if you can fly?
Here, sign this.
What is it?
It just says that we only get the nest if something happens.
What?
Just kidding, Harriet. We'll know that you'll be great.
And when we get back, it'll be time to celebrate.
Ready?
She looks like an eagle.
Set.
Look at her go.
No.
She's flying.
See why I said we're not letting you have them back? This has been the most wonderful week of camp. I saved the show I liked the best for the last week, and we also got the best group of campers for the last week, so we've had a really good time. I hope you enjoyed the show. Before we sing the Kate's Camp song, I have to recognize my absolutely amazing staff, because I really could never, ever organize this camp without them. This is my dearest friend, Miss Rihanna. She is our artistic drama director. Is Bridget Haynes, and she is actually at her boyfriend's graduation for his master's degree down in Maryland. So we thought that was an okay excuse not to be here, but she's been wonderful. So let's hear from Miss Bridget. My dance instructor, Mr. Joey Army. All this beautiful art you see on the stage is due to the talents of Miss Megan McNivens. Then I have my minions who work for free, my CITs, Mr. Von Glanville. Mr. Jeffrey Lang. Miss Marissa Astor. Counselors who get a few dollars, Emma Kindle. Ella Brady. Here's right arm, my head counselor, Mr. Parker Cook. I think for the last show, we also need to thank Jacob back in the booth. Thank you, Jacob. And Mr. Brett Elliott and all of the staff here at the Kate and the volunteer ushers who always come to work for our shows. Because really, we couldn't do it without this amazing theater. It's such a great experience for the children. So before we sing the Kate's Camp song,
before we do anything, there is one wonderful woman, Miss Martha, who has literally brought this camp to life every week for 8 weeks. I can't imagine doing this without you. None of us could do any of this without you. And we are just, I'm gonna cry. We are just so thankful that you're here. And we're so tired. We're just so thankful that you're here. And so we wanted to give you these. And we love you so, so much.
So we've always said we wanted to have a week of camp for the counselors and the staff after they go home. So last night we had a pizza party to just celebrate the end of the year, at the end of the summer, and all the counselors got up and we sang Raptors Rap for Joey. That was our camp experience. So anyway, we're going to sing the Kate's Camp song before we go, and then we hope you'll meet us down under the tent for some lemonade and cookies. Your children will be there. Meanwhile, the counselors will be gathering up all this amazing art they made and getting it down into the ballet room in their bins. Let's give them about 5 or 10 minutes to get that done, and then you can come down to collect all their stuff. Please, we already have about 6 water bottles, so come and get everything. And oh, please come back next summer. These children are just absolutely the best. We love them. Woo!